Parashat Bereshit. The first two chapters of the book of Genesis each give a different kind of picture of the human being and what he is. So explains my teacher and mentor, the great Rabbi Yosef Dov Halevi Soloveitchik, Zecher Tzadik Livracha, and in his lonely man of faith, he sees in the first chapter of Genesis Homo actus, active man who is part and parcel of the creation of the world, active man who God charges with conquering the entire world. Look at the entire world which I have made. Look at it, v'chivshua, and you must conquer it. So man is at the apex of creation, active, conquering man. The second chapter of Genesis is very different. The second chapter of Genesis speaks of the creation of the heavens and the earth, mentions that nothing had begun to grow until the human being activated creation, and he does activate creation. And the human being was created by God, afar min ha'adama, dust from the earth, in which God inspirited, breathed within the dust, his soul of life. This is a different portrait of man. It's man who is dust, not only creative, but created upon. Man who contains animalness, beastliness, to an extent, the human being who is mortal. Oh God. The human being who is mortal and who is subject to death and mortality and fears. And the human being who enters into relationships. Relationships with the God around and the God within. The human being who enters into a very deep relationship with woman and who is incomplete without woman who completes him. The second chapter of Genesis speaks of Homo passum, passive human being. Rabbi Soloveitchik's language, redemptive man, who is part animal and part God, who must redeem himself and ultimately redeem the world by establishing human and spiritual relationships, by developing the godliness within him. Active, creative man in the first chapter of Genesis flies around the world, uses his computer to get him everywhere and every place, wherever his office may be. And he's constantly involved in changing and creating. Passive man works on himself first and foremost, has time for introspectiveness. And passive man understands that human relationships take time to nurture, they cannot be done in a crowd. And they cannot be done when one is conquering and controlling. Redemptive man doesn't even strive to control. He strives to be part of a greater whole. Both of these aspects are very real parts of existential human being. And between chapter 1 and chapter 2, there's a very interesting interlude that Rav Soloveitchik doesn't mention. But I'm sure that what I'm saying is within the line of his thought. After chapter 1, Vayechulu Hashemayim V'aretz V'chol Tzva'am, and the heavens and the earth were finished and all of their hosts. Vayechal Lukim B'yom HaShvi'i Melachto Asher Asah, and God completed his work on the seventh day, and he rested on the seventh day from all of his work, creative work. And God blessed the seventh day and called it holy, because on this day, God rested from all the creative work which he had made. All of us are part creative people and part redemptive people, active and passive. Extra expansive and introspective. We have to find the balance between those two aspects of our personality. The part of us that wants to conquer and the part of us that wants to relate and redeem. Shabbat is the gift which gives us the opportunity, even if we are basically creative people, to be introspective and relationship people as well. And that's the glory and the great blessing of the Sabbath day. Shabbat Shalom.